For this lesson, you need to open the Wealth of Nations from your Sample Files folder. When you save an Excel file onto your hard disk, you're saving a single workbook containing one or more worksheets. You can add as many worksheets as you need to a workbook. There are two types of worksheet. Regular worksheets contain cells. Chart sheets, as you would expect, each contain a single chart. We'll be exploring charts in depth in Session 5. This workbook has three worksheets. Look at the tabs on the bottom left corner of your screen. Notice that there's a GDP tab, a life expectancy tab, and a mobile phones tab. I'm going to click each of these tabs in turn to view each worksheet. First, life expectancy. When I click, you're viewing the life expectancy worksheet. And now I'll click mobile phones to view the mobile phones worksheet. And now I'll click back on GDP again to see the GDP worksheet. Let's imagine now that you want to add another worksheet to this workbook called population. To do that, I click the circle with a plus in it to the right of the existing worksheets, and when I click, a new worksheet's added called Sheet 1. I'm now going to change the name of the Sheet 1 worksheet so that its name is Population. To do that, I double click on Sheet 1 and then type Population on the keyboard. Of course, the Population worksheet that we're seeing above is completely empty at the moment. Now let's imagine that I want the Population tab to be between Life Expectancy and Mobile Phones. I can move it simply by clicking on the tab and moving it to the right-hand side. And as I move it, you can see a little black arrow showing where the tab will be inserted. I want it there, between Life Expectancy and Mobile Phones. So I release the mouse button and the tab moves to its new position. Now let's talk about the tab scroll buttons. Those are the two buttons to the left of the tabs. Now, because this worksheet has only four tabs, there's no need to use the tab scroll buttons. In fact, they don't do anything when all tabs are visible. But let's imagine that this worksheet is a little narrower and you can't actually see all of the tabs. You'd then use those two tab buttons to move between the tabs on the screen. Let's now put that bottom bar back to its normal size. You can also move between worksheets using only the keyboard. To do that, hold down the Control key and press the Page Up key to move to the left, or the Page Down key to move to the right. Your workbook will look better if you colour key each of the tabs. To do that, I'll right-click on the GDP tab and then select Tab Color from the shortcut menu. It's best practice to choose a color from the top block of theme colors rather than one from the standard colors section. You'll discover why later in Lesson 4.8 and Lesson 4.10. So let's choose a green color for the GDP tab. For life expectancy, I'll choose a blue tab. For population, I'll choose a yellow tab. And for mobile phones, I'll choose an orange tab. Let's now imagine that you want to delete the population tab that you've just added. To do that, you right-click on the population tab and select Delete from the shortcut menu. Sometimes you'll have several tabs you want to delete. And to delete them all at the same time, click on the first tab you want to delete, hold down the Control key on your keyboard, and then click on the other tabs one at a time. When you've selected all the tabs you want to delete, right-click on one of the selected tabs, and then select Delete from the shortcut menu. Even though I'm going to delete these tabs, I don't need to worry about losing their data. That's because I'm going to close this workbook without saving it, so I won't overwrite the original workbook. So I'm going to click Delete now, and the two tabs disappear. It isn't possible to delete every worksheet in a workbook. A workbook always needs to contain at least one worksheet. So at this stage, I couldn't delete the GDP tab. Now let's close the workbook without saving it, so that I don't lose the information in those other tabs. I'll click the Close button at the top right of the screen, and I'm warned that I've made changes to this workbook and I haven't saved them. But I don't want to save them, so I click the Don't Save button to preserve the original state of the workbook. You've now completed Lesson 1-9. View, Move, Add, Rename, Delete and Navigate Worksheet Tabs.